sometimes she will. When streams are ripe and swelled with rain, may she will stay, resting in my arms again. June, she changed her tune. In restless walks she'll prowl the night. July, she will fly and give no warning of her flight. August, die she must. The autumn winds blow chilly and cold. September, I'll remember the love once knew has now grown old.
Hey there, folks. Going to be a guitar lesson for April Come She Will by the fabulous Simon and Garfunkel. What a song. I wasn't planning to do a lesson on this one. There's lots of tutorials, I think, there are on YouTube for this one. But, you know, with the arrival of spring, with the arrival of April and the beautiful weather in the northeast of the United States, I've just been in a mood for this song. I've been playing it a lot. So I decided, why not put a lesson out there? I will say, Paul Simon is a masterful guitarist. I can't come anywhere close to him, so I've simplified this greatly. So this is kind of a simplified version, the Judge Timbers version of this. And certainly, if you want to play this the way Paul does on the record, watch another YouTuber for those, you know, precise lessons. But this will get you pretty close. The other thing, let me just point out that I'm doing really the live version from the Central Park concert. It's my favorite version of this song. Art's vocals are just beautiful. The music, the guitar playing is just so spectacular in front of such a large crowd. That if you have not watched that, definitely watch the whole show, but at least watch this song for sure. It's just absolutely mesmerizing. So in that version at Central Park, Paul's capoing the guitar at the third fret. So that's what I did for this lesson. The original studio version is recorded in a different key, so I'm not sure what that is. So I'm just going to give you the live version again, a simplified way. So let's start. So again, capo on the third fret, the guitar is in standard tuning. We're going to start with a G shape. I'm going to call it a G with the capo on three, a G. But for the intro, which is the same as the outro, the G I'm going to play at the seventh fret with a D shape. Now, I've told you this before, folks. I'm not a finger picker. I'm not really sure. I cannot teach finger picking. I really do it by ear, by touch. I do what's comfortable to me, what I think I can do without making too many mistakes. So to me, the key is play it your own way, play it in your comfort level, and try not to make too many mistakes. A few mistakes is fine. We all do, and I certainly do. So I can't really teach this, but I'm just going to show you what I'm doing. So I'm in a D shape at the seventh fret, which would be a G chord, obviously. So you got a G there. So same chord. And I'm going to pluck the four and the one together. And then the rest, I think you have to do by ear. So it's going to sound something like this, the intro and the outro. And then I'm going to slide from the 7th fret to the 5th fret, and I'm going to play a D chord. Again, however you want to pick it is fine, but it's a D chord. And then it brings this resolves to the G, where the song starts, so G. And you could hear I'm doing that C over G, which I'm going to assume you know how to do if you're watching this lesson. So you're in a G chord, and then I'm just going to add the C shape with the G bass. So a C over G is at least what I call it. And I'm going to hammer on the C. that's a very common Paul Simon kind of guitar playing technique. So however you want to do it. Again, I probably do it differently every time, but it sounds wonderful. So that's the intro, and now in the verse, you just go the G, C over G, G over, it starts with that, so with the April. So it's
April, come she will.
So again, just that G, C over G, I just do it that way. Keep it simple. And then we're going to go, it's going to start with an A minor and go to an E minor with something in a couple of things in between. So an A minor. So it's
when streams are ripe and swelled with rain.
So what I'm doing is, let me just play it. So it's going to start with an A minor. Then we're going to add a G bass note and open up the B string. So I guess it would be an A sus 2 over G. At least that's what I'm going to call it. Sounds like that. And keep that shape, but go to an F bass note. So an A sus 2 over F, we'll call it. And then just a regular E minor. So again, A minor. Add the G. Add the F. E minor. Now we're going to go...
May she will stay.
So that's a C, D, G. Walk it down F sharp to an E minor. Now the first two verses, three verses, very short song. What a beautiful song. It's so short. The first two times it's just A minor, back to E minor, back to A minor, to E minor. Then walk up to the G. So when I say walk up, you're in E minor, play E, F sharp to a G. Then the same G, C over G. So first two verses, exactly the same. Now we'll go to the third verse. I'll just talk you through it, and then I'll show you there's a little difference in the last line. And that's it, folks. So you're in the G. So,
oh.
Now the A minor, add the G, open up the B, add the F to E minor. Then we go to C to a D, G, walk it down E minor, that's all the same. Now A minor, a love once E minor has now. Now a D, that's different, D. Then the outro is exactly the same as the intro. So you're back onto the seventh fret. So you're in a D. Grown. And just slide the shape up to the seventh fret. Oh. That's it, folks. That is April Come She Will by the legendary Simon and Garfunkel. Again, one of my all-time favorite songs. I just love this one. I love so many of those, of theirs. Again, I don't do too many lessons because I find most of their songs are difficult to play on guitar and beyond my ability sometimes. But anyway, folks, I hope you're enjoying the great weather where you are in the northeast of the United States. You know, spring has sprung and April is in the air. The birds are flying. It's warming up. So I hope you're all doing well. Everybody stay safe. I'll see you all soon with another guitar tutorial. Take care.